AFL Commission hearing into Essendon's supplement scandal is threatening to spill into a third day. The football world is still waiting for a resolution to the story which has dogged the AFL since early February. It's now been 204 days since the Bombers self-reported. Another day of marathon talks behind closed doors has taken place at league headquarters. And that's where we find reporter Emma O'Sullivan. So Emma, are the parties any closer to a deal tonight?
Mel, the short answer is we believe so. This is unlike any court process. There's been no actual hearing before the AFL commissioners. Just as you said, more talks. We've just got word that Bomber Thompson, Mark Thompson, has left. He said that his case hasn't been resolved and added it doesn't look like Essendon is playing finals. The league has indicated it's losing patience, and if this isn't resolved soon, this could be headed for a contested hearing before the AFL. Now, that's something that James Heard has always objected to. He wants any charge against him heard by an independent body, and he would want it heard in public like any normal court hearing. But the fact that these negotiations are continuing suggests that the league wants to keep this behind closed doors. Holding out for a better deal, James Heard left home early for another day in the fight to clear his name.
James, are you anywhere near a resolution here?
He joined the other three Essendon officials charged for bringing the game into disrepute for a second day of intense talks.
Good morning, everyone.
Today, none of the key players were speaking on the saga everyone's talking about. Chairman Paul Little and CEO Ray Gunston wouldn't reveal if talks on the club's behalf are progressing.
Were the AFL reasonable yesterday in their negotiations?
I'm not commenting on anything at the moment, so we'll see how we go today.
It's reported the league has issued Essendon an ultimatum: make a deal today or risk harsher sanctions. The Bombers are still expected to face a record-breaking fine against an AFL club and a ban on playing finals. The club is also still expected to face a loss of draft picks, for this year at least. The AFL is said to have told the club suspending James Heard from coaching for 12 months is non-negotiable. Heard is believed to be unhappy with the wording of the charges against him. For now, his threat of going it alone in the Supreme Court remains very much alive. This morning, there were high hopes that a deal could at least be settled between the league and Essendon, but things are still being thrashed out. The four Essendon officials charged, they arrived here around 11 o'clock this morning. Mel?
Thanks to Emma O'Sullivan, reporting there from AFL House. Well, it's football's biggest drama, and the main characters have been keeping a huge media contingent on their feet. Rob Waters was at AFL headquarters last night as Melbourne's most watched show finished in a stalemate.
They talked and haggled and argued into the night. Danny Corcoran bizarrely left with a no comment in French.
Je ne peux parler avec vous parce que mes avocats m'ont dit ça.
Dr. Bruce Reid left stoically and silently. James Heard wasn't stopping for anyone, particularly the media, and Bomber Thompson headed to the 360 studios.
Heardy's coming now. You want to get Heardy. I'm serious. He is. Big fish.
No players have been charged. We've broken no AFL rules or codes, and no players have used prohibited substances. So for us to accept what we're being offered, I think has been very, very generous and kind.
Tim Watson says the AFL has deliberately drawn the timing out to suit its finals agenda.
They're a well-oiled machine, the AFL, OK? Mm. Now, they've engineered this in a way that it will be completed in a time that suits them. And I've always thought that this was going to be the week before the last game that Essendon played, so they could wrap it up neatly before the finals.
Nathan Buckley had his say.
If my players were being injected, I would know about that. Mm. And I would want to know what was in the syringe.
Through it all, James Heard is fighting to save his reputation and career.
If he was to lose 12 months, it'd be disastrous. I would think that if the AFL knocked him out for 12 months, he would struggle to want to get back.
Lawyers were last night bogged down in the wording of the charges and the agreed penalties, and there was an element of every man for himself. But the AFL is growing impatient at the pace of negotiations and might adopt a take-it-or-leave-it approach. Rob Waters, 10 News.